Tonight on Face the Press, we're going to examine two different views of contemporary things. On my left is the Minister for Home Affairs, who is wearing a striking organza dress in pink jewel with matching pearls and a Diamante collar necklace. The shoes are in brushed pigskin with girl clasps by Maxwell of Bond Street. The hair is by Roger, and the whole ensemble is crowned by a spectacular display of Christmas orchids. And on my right, putting the case against the government, is a small patch of brown liquid. Which could be creosote or some extract used in industrial varnishing. Good evening. Minister, may I put the first question to you? In your plan, A Better Britain for Us, you claim that you would build 88,000 million billion houses a year in the Greater London area alone. In fact, you built only three in the last 15 years. Are you a bit disappointed with this result?
No, no. I'd like to answer this question, if I may, in two ways. Firstly, in my normal voice, and then in a kind of silly, high-pitched whine. See, housing is a problem, really.
Well, while the Minister the is answering this question, I'd just like to point out that the Minister's dress has been made entirely by hand from over 300 pieces of Arabian shot silk. Specially created for the Minister by Vargas of Paris. The low, slim line has been cut off the shoulder to heighten the effect of the Minister's fine hair.
Such a morning in the High Court. I could stamp my little feet the way those QCs carry on.
Don't I know it, though?
Objection here, objection there. That nice policeman giving his evidence so well. Beautiful speaking voice. Well, after a bit, all I could do was bang my little gavel.
You what, though?
I banged my gavel.
Oh.
I did my silencing court bit. Oh, if looks could kill, that prosecuting counsel would be in for 30 years. How did your summing up go?
Well, I was quite pleased, actually. I was trying to do my butch voice, you know, what the jury must understand. And they loved it, you know, because see that foreman eyeing me.
Really?
Yes, cheeky devil.
Was it the tall man with that very
no,
big...
just a minute, I must finish, you know. Anyway, I finished up with, the actions of these vicious men is a violent stain on the community, and the full penalty of the law is scarcely sufficient to deal with their ghastly crimes. And I waggle my wig. Just ever so slightly. But it was a stunning effect.
Oh, I bet it was. Like that super tan warlock striped robe in the magistrate's court.
Oh, I
see something decent and military. Some precision drilling. Squad! Camp it! Up!
Who get her? Whoops! I've got your number that you couldn't afford me, dear 2-3. I'll scratch your eyes out. Don't come the brigadier bit with us, dear. We all know where you've been, you military fairy.
2-3, 1-2-3-4-5-6.
Whoops! Don't look now, girls. The major's just minced in with a dolly colour sergeant.
2-3.
Ooh!
Right, stop that. Silly. And a bit suspect, I think.
Inspector?
Yes, sir.
I was sitting on a park bench just now, and I put my coat down. When I picked it up again, I found my wallet had gone and £15 had been stolen.
Did you see anyone?
No, no one at all.
Well, there's very little we can do about that, sir. Do you want to come back to my place?
Well, I was ever so glad they abolished hanging, you know, because that black cap just didn't suit me.
Yes. Do you remember the Glasgow treason trial?
Oh, yes, I wore a body stocking all through it.
No, Hen, at the party afterwards.
Oh, that's right. You were walking out with that very butch clerk of the court.
That's right. Oh, he made me want to turn Queen's evidence.
Oh, me too. One summing up on a minibodies.
Oh, anyway. Bailey Anderson.
Oh, her?
Yeah, she's so strict. She was on at me for giving Dolly sentences, you know. Especially in that arson case.
What was the verdict?
They preferred the brown wig.
I love the Scottish assizes. I know what they mean by a really well-hung jury.
Oh, get back in the witness box. You're too sharp to live.
I'll smack your little body.
Oh, and again.
Have you heard side of that new body rub JP's use?
I had a magistrate in Bradford yesterday.
Funnily enough, I felt like one in a lunchtime recess today. But the ones I really like are those voiceover announcers on the BBC, you know, after the programmes are over.
Oh, aye, of course, they're bent as safety pins.
I know, but they've got beautiful speaking voices, haven't they? And now a choice of viewing on BBC television.
Here are tonight's football results.